sweet of you. Well, has it ever come down to you having to protect with your own life?
Well, no. But one time, this burglar walked by the house real slow. I had my taser out just in case.
What would we do without you?
I'd rather know, Martha Ann. How is the little fry today?
Well, Dr. Harleen over there seems to think she's fine.
You are a doctor!
Yes, Fairy June. Harleen went to Dallas and became a doctor.
Congratulations!
You know, the best thing to do in situations like this is to treat the bereaved exactly as you would any other day. As chairwoman of the Sunshine Committee, I've been faced with this sort of grief all the time. Be kind, but not too kind. Some folks can't take too much goodwill.
Well, then, it's a good thing you don't have a lot of that to hand out anyway.
Good morning, everyone. Beautiful day, isn't it? My doing would have approved.
Hi, Mama. How are you doing? Doing okay over there?
Oh, I'm fine. It's fine. Just came for a little pick-me-up before the service. Can somebody explain to me why I overheard Dewdrop talking to Beecham about building a time machine?
It's a long story, Mama. But you look lovely.
Oh, thank you, Sammy Jo. Ozella, I see you're here. It is so kind of you to volunteer to stay here at the house today while we're away at the service. I know it will be hard, but please, do your darndest not to dig through every drawer in this house.
Harleen, I mean, it's not personal.
Yes, it is, Addie. It's very personal.
nobody.
Well, isn't that worth something? You think he'd want to see his green widow thrown out of her house? You think he'd want to see everything he worked for go down the dump?
Well, the law isn't always fair, Harleen.
Fair? Who cares about fair? This is my family we're talking about, Addie. There's got to be something you can do.
Well, I'd help your mama if I could.
Would you?
I like to say hi, but we ain't stopping, we go right outside.
Bye, dear Jane.
Hey, Atticus.
What's up, Peachum?
You having a talk with Harleen?
Yeah.
Well, good luck to you. God help him, man. He's talking to one of the sisters' fry.
Yeah, he's right about that.
Not exactly right. I mean, at least I get to talk to you.
Him and that Sammy Joe, I'll tell you one thing. I never would have stuck my hand in the bag and pulled the two of them out together.
Well, I think what Beecham and Sammy Joe have is wonderful. They seem to genuinely like each other. Well, today notwithstanding. But they have two beautiful boys and they have fun together. They have family, Abby. That's what I'm talking about. Family. My family. You know, I've been thinking over the last several months about family, and well, I don't really have one of those down in Dallas. Of course, I have friends, but that's not really the same thing. I've been thinking real seriously about moving back here.
What are you doing? Why are you starting that?
I ain't starting nothing. I haven't been down in Dallas trying to better myself over the last 10 years. I've been trying to prove to my family who I really am. But I was wrong. Mom and Daddy knew who I was all along. They were just waiting on me to get there. Well, I just really hate that I had to go all the way down to Dallas to do that. Oh, what now? Good Lord. Y'all go on down to the church and we'll meet you there. Can a woman get any privacy around here? Jesus, family time. I'm going. Now, what was I saying?
You know that's the most open you've been with me in years.
Well, that's the most open I've been with anybody in years.
Well, we used to talk like that all the time.
Well, I remember when we didn't talk much at all.
Oh, correct. That's what I like about you.
Oh, Eddie, I like everything about you.
Oh, Lord, what are we going to do, you and me?
Well, I guess we can't do much until we get all this sorted out.
You know what you need?
A hitman to take out on the dub?
Well, that's one way to go about it, I guess. No, seeing as how you got a legal problem, I'd say you need a lawyer.
What I need is a lawyer that's smarter than you.
Well, how about a lawyer just as smart as me? Would you like to retain my counsel, Mrs. Fry?
Ooh, you are picking the wrong time to come on to me, Addie.
Well, I'll need a retainer if you're so inclined.
I do what?
A retainer. You have to hire me, Harleen. Here, put that on my phone.
Oh, I know that trick.
If you hire me, Harleen, then I can go to work for you.
So we don't need a contract?
Well, I mean that would work, but I ain't got one of them on me.
Oh, look here. I'll fix that real quick.
What are you doing?
Put it right here on this napkin.
Now, Harleen, I'm pretty sure that a contract written on a napkin's not too official.
Well, in my experience, contracts written on napkins are the most official.
Well, let's see what you got here. All right. Atticus Van Leer is my law.
Oh, that's a Y. It says all your fault.
All right, well, you need to sign it.
There. What now, law you man?
Well, I got pie all over my phone. Lord have mercy. Well, I'll need to tell Doug first.
Well, we're going to do that today?
Yeah, but I'll have to officially resign from it.
Well, why?
Well, because I can't work for both of you, Harleen. I'd be disbarred.
Oh, yeah. Well, I know I don't have a law degree from Ole Miss, but here's what we can do. Mm-hmm. You can take me down to your office.